WNDS Sports presents New England's favorite bowling show. From Lita Lanes in Nashua, New Hampshire. Featuring the best bowlers from around the region. Candlepin Stars and Strikes. And now your hosts, Dick Lutz and Mike Morin.
Hello again, everybody, and welcome into another edition of Candlepin Stars and Strikes on WNDS-TV from Lita Lanes in Nashua, New Hampshire. Dick Lutz with Mike Morin. And we have reached the top of the ladder for our first ladder series of the new season. What a great match we had last week.
Tell you what, Jackie Ray had a nice run for 3 weeks, lost by 2 pins. The week before, he won by 8 pins. So they're very interesting matches. And today, a returning Tournament of Champion finalist, Jeff Surette, is here.
All right, let's meet our two contestants in this, the last match of the first ladder series, the winner advancing to the Tournament of Champions. Last week's winner, 375 to 373 over Jackie Ray. Our number two seed from Pembroke, Massachusetts. Let's say hi to Mike Cuccia.
Mike Cuccia averaging 120. His high single is 203. Best triple, 506. Bowling at a number of different establishments. Hanover Bowlodrome, Lucky Strike in Dorchester, and the Park Place Sunday Couples League.
Mike rolled a 668 in the roll-off to earn the number two seed, and he seeded right behind the top seed, who rolled a 683 in the roll-off to gain the number one seed from Tewksbury, Massachusetts. We welcome back Jeff Surette.
No stranger to the Stars and Strikes cameras, for sure. You saw him just a few months ago in the Tournament of Champions, averaging 128. Best single is 202. High triple 475, and his home bowling center is where he works also at Candlewood in North Reading.
Shapes up to be a great match. Mike Cuccia and Jeff Surette, let's get right to it. We're coming right back to Lita Lanes in Nashua for Candlepin Stars and Strikes on WNDS-TV right after this. We began with five great bowlers, and we're down to two. Mike Cuccia and Jeff Surette meeting for the championship of this ladder series. Jackie Ray won a couple of matches before losing to Cuccia by 2 pins last week, setting up this afternoon's match with the winner advancing to the Tournament of Champions at the end of the year. And Mike Cuccia will be first to bowl here at Lita Lanes in Nashua, New Hampshire. What a thrilling match we had last week. Went right down to the last box. Mike Cuccia with a strike in the 10th frame to win it by 2 pins over Jackie Ray. Cuccia leads off with a good first ball.
He told me after the match, Mike did, that he was happy to get that strike because it was a spare he didn't have to shoot and possibly miss. He missed a couple of easy ones.
Including one in the 9th frame.
Yes.
Before the 10th frame.
Which could have taken the pressure off, but he came through. He rose to the occasion.
Missed the spare there.
And it was great to see Jack Ray. It had been 5 years, and it's always a fan favorite, so we're glad that he made it on the show for 3 weeks, but fell a little bit short of making it to the championship round.
Mike opens with a 9 box. Mike Cuccia, 49 years old.
Actually 50 by time.
50 by the time you're watching this. Yeah. That's correct, in October.
No, you know something? Let me correct that again. He'll turn 50 next year. He'll shoot us. Born in 1955. So you were right, 49.
I should learn not to read your notes. Missed the spare, thought he had it. You could tell by the look on his face that he turned back. He thought he made the shot.
Well, you don't want to give Jeff Surette too much leeway here by starting out with a couple of opens because he is a much explosive bowler.
And we have watched Jeff Surette grow up on this show, haven't we?
We have, indeed. He's 21 now.
And he starts off with a good first ball.
Well, the wood is frozen, so even if he hits it where he doesn't, the spare should go.
And he did. He made it. Jeff suffered the loss of his dad over the past several months. A well-known figure in Candlepin bowling. The bowling community mourned. Jeff with another mark.
Replay?
And you watch it again. I say the bowling community mourned. The bowling community came together at that time, as it does so often in times of need. There's a strike by Mike Cuccia.
Tom Surette had a lot of friends. He'd been very involved in not only the bowling industry and competitive action, but certainly as a father of three children and wife, Jean. Jean is here today, as is young Scott, much younger brother of Jeff, and a potential television competitor. I was watching him bowl here before Jeff went on the other side of the house, and he's doing pretty good. His name is Scott, sitting right next to his big brother, Jeff.
Mike Cuccia working on the strike. Tough shot here. He's going for the wood on the right and missed it. And it'll be a nine box for Mike Cuccia. Jeff Surette works on a double mark to begin. He's looking at bonus money right off the bat. Jeff, a graduate of Tewksbury High School, working at Candlewood Lanes.
Pin is still moving on the deck, the piece of wood, a little bit behind the closest, the object pin, which is the two.
Which is also still wobbling. Missed it.
So no bonus money this time, but I suspect we'll probably have a few occasions to give Jeff some bonus money today. We always do.
That's a nice 10 box right there. There's a strike in the fourth frame. He changed his approach a little bit. I'm watching Jeff Surette, and I'm watching his delivery, and it looked like he might have changed it a little bit. We'll talk about it when we see him again. And you saw the replay of the strike. Now Mike Cuccia steps up to lane 34. And throws it right in the pocket. And he will have a makeable spare right here with that wood in the back helping out. You've got the 3, 5, 10.
But I think you'd rather have the six still up, which fell.
The five still stands. Mike's a mail processor supervisor for the U.S. Postal Service in Boston. He takes a nine box.
A two-pin victory over Jack Ray last week. His last appearance prior to that was a couple of years ago, 3 years ago, when he tied Gary Santora at 345. And when that happens, we have a two-frame roll-off. So in the first two boxes, they tied again at 19. Then on the second sudden death overtime, it was Santora beating Cuccia 30 to 26. So no stranger to close matches, Mike Cuccia. And he fought back all last week and didn't finally take the lead till midway or late through the third string against Jack Ray, who he eventually went on to beat.
And that'll be a nine box. Now you watch Jeff Surette. Is he approaching more from the left to the right than we used to see him? Maybe not.
Tough to say. If it is, it's maybe just a couple of boards, but it's worth asking him at the end of the show when we talk to the bowlers.
And another mark. Jeff Surette, four marks in five boxes.
Really one of the bright spots in today's Candlepin bowling is Jeff Surette. From a competitor point of view and from just a nice guy.
Seven in the spare, tough shot here. Another try for bonus money, but this is not a gimme for sure. So stymied in his effort to win some bonus money thus far with two marks and open, two marks and an open. And that'll be a nine box.
Out to a sizable 23-pin lead after six boxes.
Mike Cuccia with some work to do.
Thank you. Well, our runner-up today, of course, receives $1,000, and with enhanced prize money that began last year, $1,500 for today's winner and a seat in the Tournament of Champions.
I want to acknowledge some emails and letters that we've received from the last season held over through the summer months, and we're catching up on acknowledging them, if not reading all of them. Joe Smith from Woburn, Massachusetts. Joe, thanks for your note. We always appreciate hearing from you.
Emails or snail mail, we're happy to hear from you.
Email address, bowling@wnds.com. Mike Cuccia will have a tough shot to make right here.
Well, it's a 7-9 with some wood at a bit of an angle in front of the 9 pin. So we'll see which side he goes for.
Got a note from Ann Adamowitz of Ipswich, Massachusetts. Ann, thank you very much for your note. We appreciate hearing from you.
Well, only one mark for Mike Cuccia through 8, and Jeff Surette has 4 in 6 boxes and continues to add to his lead, which is already at 23 pins through completed boxes.
And a mark or two here would open some daylight. Well, he's got an active ball, doesn't he? Really,
he really
creates
does.
A lot of action when it hits the pins.
Just a very natural swing and good spin on the ball.
Missed the spare, though.
He is human. Missing the single pin. But he's got a little room to play with here. He still is ahead 26 pins through now 7 completed frames. Highest score today, bowler gets $50 plus the other bonus money he earns, and a 3-bagger, 3 strikes in a row. This week is up to $575. We had $25 for each week that goes by that we do not have a winner. Bonus ball at the end of the show, $40. And there's another makeable spare missed by Jeff Surette, who's your top seed in the current ladder. He'll hope for a 10 and take a 9. Well, he could have really added some pins to his lead, but now it's at 25. Mike Cuccia, a couple of marks here will tighten things up, depending on what Surette does, of course.
It is a 25-pin lead for Jeff Surette right now. Cuccia with a spread eagle.
Wow. He just had one of those a couple boxes ago. Same lane.
Bob M. from Brockton, Mass. wrote us a note. Bob, thank you very much. Nice to hear from you. This came in during the summer months, dated August, and watching the reruns during the summer months, and thanks for your communication. You can write us at WNDS-TV, 50 Television Place, Derry, New Hampshire, 03038.
We try to pick some of the more interesting matches and schedule them as reruns during the summer. We also put the entire women's and men's doubles action all 4 weeks of that, and we also give you the entire Tournament of Champions. So you get 2 ladders intact, and then you get some of the best of the other ones.
There's a good first ball by Mike Cuccia. And a piece of wood sets up. Well, it might have angled a little too far to help him out.
He's just got to graze it just right, Dick, on the right of that
tough piece of wood.
It's a great shot when it goes, a pretty sweep shot from right to left. Needs it
He's
for 100.
Try and just touch it, not going to make it.
Missed it by 2 inches. So he'll settle for a sub-100 game. Try it again. Too full. And a 97 for Mike Cuccia.
First drink for Cuccia. Jeff Surette's already at 105. Good first ball for Jeff. He's got the 5, 8, and 9 with no wood to help out. And he made the spare. Wasn't textbook, but it goes in the book as a line drive, as they say.
Tenth frame, looking to fill it big. Puts a 6 inside his 9th frame spare, but a difficult split to make. The 2, 4, 6, and 10, and there's no wood. Chopping the two off of four. Best he can get here, probably a nine. That would give him a 130 game. And he gets eight.
After one, a 32-pin lead for Jeff Surette over Mike Cuccia. We continue with string number two from Lita Lanes in Nashua. It's Candlepin Stars and Strikes on WNDS-TV. String number two from Lita Lanes in Nashua, New Hampshire, with Jeff Surette leading Mike Cuccia by 32 pins, 129 to 97. The score after one, Jeff Surette leading off the string with a strike. Let off the first string with a couple of spares, and string number two wastes no time in getting back on the board with a mark. Shifting over to lane 33. Right on the head pin, can he bust up the split? No.
But he's got a nice piece of wood leaning up against the six pin.
The director of Candlepin Stars and Strikes on WNDS-TV is Kevin LaFawn. Rich Burke is on audio. Kristen Duby's our timer. Eric Angra works the replay machine.
Oh,
and
my.
Nice shot by Jeff Surette.
Wow.
Well done. Just doesn't get any nicer than that. Watch it again. And he cut it over beautifully, didn't he? Just a well-executed shot by Jeff Surette.
That was textbook.
Keith Webb's our engineer. Patrick McDougall, Greg Amabello, and Larry Haber. Our camera crew making it possible for you to watch Candlepin Stars and Strikes on WNDS. And Mike Cuccia responds with a mark.
And he better not stop yet. Jeff Surette's strung two together here, and he shows no signs of stopping.
We haven't given away any bonus money yet this afternoon. We'd like to. Cuccia with a good first ball, nine-pin drop. Tough shot here. The wood didn't help him out. He would like that wood to get out of the way. Roll one or two more times.
It's rolling
into the gutter.
There
it goes. So a clear shot at the 10 pin for Mike Cuccia. And he's right on it.
Nice concentration on a difficult spare under pressure.
I think the last part of it was the toughest part, the pressure situation, because he's facing Jeff Surette with a couple of marks, trailing by 30 pins going in, and he really needs to mark. He can't let Surette go without answering. Surette put seven in his spare.
It's a difficult split, but he also made one just a moment ago that you saw, the 2-6 and 10. Too far to the right.
And I was going to say, if he made that, we might as well just pack up and go home.
You might want to ask Cuccia what he feels about that idea.
He ended up with a 10 box.
Look at that.
There's a strike for Jeff Surette.
Acknowledging a couple of cat calls from the audience with a, okay, I'll show you.
Three marks and four boxes for Jeff Surette. Here's Mike Cuccia. Mike again needs to respond. He puts seven in his spare.
It was a nice shot, but just a little too full.
And he's got a tough shot here. Can't skip the wood over there to take out the seven pin. So he'll be open in the third, as was Surette. And a nice shot to pick up the 10. That was not nearly as easy as it looked.
Got a pin in the left gutter on lane 33, which Mike Cuccia will roll the ball down to get rid of, and he acknowledged that to Jeff. I'm going to, you know, this is not my shot. This is to get rid of the pin in the channel.
On lane 33, Mike Cuccia with the pocket shot, and will it kick it? The eight pin got tapped and nudged and shook, but wouldn't go.
As these guys battled almost pin by pin in this second game.
Good cover that time, and we go to the break. Both bowlers working on marks. a 33-pin lead for Jeff Surette over Mike Cuccia as we approach the halfway point on Candlepin Stars and Strikes from Lita Lanes in Nashua. You are watching WNDS-TV. Jeff Surette, the youngster from Tewksbury, on lane 34 at Lita Lanes. Right on the head pin. Not much to show for his effort, though. Working on a strike, has another ball to fill the mark.
There's a 7 fill on the strike. Jeff Surette, winner of the 2003 Tournament of Champions, defeating Mike Morgan, 362 to 316. That was a $2,000 payday for Mr. Surette.
73 half here for Jeff.
Also 2003, 2004, both years in a row. Here's the interesting thing is he won the Tom Morgan Memorial Tournament the past 2 Augusts.
And he strikes in the 6th frame.
Tom Morgan.
Watch it again. You'll see, I think it was the 4-pin. Or was it the, no, it was the 8-pin.
The
8-pin in the back. That was a little bit reluctant, but finally coaxed over. Here's a good pocket shot by Mike Cuccia to respond. Answering the challenge, 2 marks in a row, 4 marks and 5 boxes for Cuccia. That was a good pocket shot by Mike. And again, the 8-pin was the last to go.
It's turning out to be quite a shootout day.
He's looking for bonus money right here. We'd like to give some away. That one got away from him.
Oh.
He's working on a strike. He picked one, picked the 2-pin cleanly off the pack, which you couldn't do if you tried. Another ball to fill the strike, though. Well, he was a little too full on the head pin on that. Only 5 goes in the mark. And an 8 box.
Started to mention here a moment ago that Jeff Surette beat Mike Morgan in the 2003 Tournament of Champions and has gone on to win 2 consecutive Tom Morgan Memorial Tournaments. Tom Morgan passing away a couple of years ago, and the tournament has been set up in his honor. And it's interesting that the brother, the late Tom Morgan, is who he beat in the Tournament of Champions and has since gone on to win both those tournaments in the memory of Tom Morgan, the Memorial Tournaments past 2 August. So congratulations to Jeff. 2 very nice tournaments to be a winner of.
So Jeff puts a spare inside the strike. Another opportunity for bonus money here. Right in the pocket. There they go. Finally, bonus money to give away. $50 in bonus money for Jeff Surette.
Replay.
And those pins went down in no time flat. And now we're back to Mike Cuccia, and another one for Cuccia. He buried it in the pocket that time.
Well, double here would get a few pins back, but he completed frames, is 14 pins behind in this game. Added to the 25 that he was behind after game one. He's looking at a 4-mark deficit, but he could make up some ground with a double right here. Missed the head pin. It's the 1-2-9-10. There is no wood. So he's going to have to make it a clean shot. Oh, my. A beauty that was.
And Mike Cuccia responds.
Replay.
Watch it again. Oh, the ball did a lot of the work going straight through. How odd is that?
That is a very odd way to make that spare. I was shocked to see it go.
And Jeff missed the head pin on that one, but he's still working on a strike. Another ball to fill the strike. Oh, he almost made it. Left the 7-pin.
It's almost a shock when he doesn't make a spare, isn't it? And you say, wow, Jeff missed that?
And that'll be a 9 box. He's at 141 through 9.
Well, our winner today is going into the Tournament of Champions in April, and the higher the score, the better the seeding, as you know. Jeff's going to be sitting at, well, if he makes a spare, pretty close to 290 after two games. But that, of course, assumes that he does win. Can't assume that.
He's at 150. Got a note from Art Sini Jr. from Fitchburg, who says, we talked about movies with Candlepin bowling. Have there been any? And he points out, he sends in a clipping of a listing of a Lifetime television show called Catch a Falling Star, which he says was just about a mill in New Hampshire, and has a Candlepin background, and was shot in Lebanon, a Lebanon, New Hampshire
background. No
kidding.
I'll be darned.
A bowling center in it. So Art Sini, thanks very much. This is from, it doesn't give the date. Well, he wrote
check
it in
TV
August.
Guide page there.
He wrote it in August. And it just doesn't give the date on the page. There's a nice shot by Mike Cuccia.
Two fabulous back-to-back spare conversions by Mike Cuccia. And he's got a chance to make up some ground right here because Jeff Surette has opens in the ninth and tenth. As you take another look at it, a perfect cut shot. But he's got to come through now if he has any hope of staying with Jeff in the next game.
Right through, spread eagle.
Well, we saw Jack Ray make this a couple of weeks ago.
And an 8 box from Mike Cuccia and a 148. Second string to Jeff Surette's 151. So Surette adds 3 pins to his lead. A 35-pin lead for Jeff Surette over Mike Cuccia as we go to the third and final string from Lita Lanes in Nashville. We continue with Candlepin Stars and Strikes on WNBS-TV. Mike Cuccia will bowl first in our third string, trailing Jeff Surette by 35 pins from Lita Lanes in Nashua. Dick Lutz with Mike Morin. Great to have you with us as we conclude our first ladder series of the season. Want to acknowledge a note we got from William Smith from Quincy, a frequent writer to us, Michael, and he's the one who has updated us on Larry Glick several times.
Oh, sure.
Larry is a greeter at Legal Seafoods in Boca Raton, Florida, at 82 years young.
I can see Larry doing that. Good start for Mike Cuccia, finding himself 35 pins behind Jeff Surette with 10 boxes to go. Another pesky near spread eagle. The 7-pin went down, so he's got 5 instead of 6 standing.
We did give $50 in bonus money to Mike Cuccia in that string, as well as Jeff Surette, both earning $50 in bonus money for 3 marks in a row. Mike with a little body English couldn't help that shot. And he'll have to settle for an 8 box. Can't afford many of those.
There's your spread eagle with a little surprise filling.
With the 5 pin right in the middle. And look at this, look at this. It goes.
Wow.
The spread eagle with the 5 pin. The 3 pin, the last to kick out, and there it goes. Wow.
We have seen some spare shooting the last couple of weeks.
There's a pocket shot.
Well, this is a walk in the park compared to what he just made.
This is the 410 with some wood on the deck. He plays the wood, not making it. He was hoping for a ricochet somewhere along the line. Didn't get it. Has to take a 10 box.
Adding yet another 5 pins to his lead.
So now it's 40 with 8 frames remaining. Can he kick out that 4 pin? Get out of that split. Can't do it. Gonna have to bounce some wood off the left wall and hope it comes across and takes out the 6 and the 10. Nope.
Well,
he got the 10 with the ball. Wasn't planning on doing it that way. Nine box.
Time running out for Mike Cuccia. One of these two bowlers will be seen again in the spring, our Tournament of Champions. Take the winner in each of our 6 men's ladders, put them in a head-to-head tournament. 5 weeks, 6 bowlers, till we have a winner, and $2,000 for the top prize.
Mary Sorrow from Worcester, Massachusetts, wrote us a nice note. Mike, thank you, Mary. Nice to hear from you. We appreciate hearing from all of you who watch Candlepin Stars and Strikes each and every week on WNDS-TV. As Mike Cuccia will be open in the 4th frame. And he's running out of frames. And he has to settle for an 8 box. Jeff Surette could stick a dagger in with a couple of marks right here. There's a spare by the shot maker. Jeff Surette. Great shot by Surette. Second mark of the 3rd string, increasing his lead. That one got away from him a little bit. Just puts 4 in the spare.
Well, he's made more difficult spares today, for sure.
Yeah, all these pins are too close together. Bounces it down.
He has such confidence, such poise.
And a 9 box, he adds another pin to his lead. He leads by 46 with 6 boxes remaining. We take a break from Lita Lanes in Nashua. We continue from Candlepin Stars and Strikes on WNDS-TV. Mike Cuccia ready to bowl on lane 34. First ball's a good one, but he doesn't have a lot to show from it unless he kicks out the 10 pin, which he does. For a minute, he had the 8 and 10 in the back row, but the 10 went down, leaving him a clear shot at the 8 pin and a mark, which he desperately needs. And he's right on it.
He can ill afford any more than maybe one open frame here.
He's a good pin picker, too. He's been shown that accuracy over the course of the last couple of weeks. Good first ball and a strike.
Now he needs 4 more frames like the last couple to be in this thing, being 46 pins behind.
There's the replay, in case you missed it the first time.
Makeable, but not easy. It's the 2 and the 7, and the wood is not really a factor here.
Well, it almost was a factor. It almost became a factor. Spraying all over the place. So he's going to be open, giving Cuccia an opportunity to gain some ground. And now he's up against a Mike Cuccia strike. right through the middle. It's a spread eagle.
Well, Jeff, you made this one with the five pin a few minutes ago.
It was easier then. Look at this.
Wow.
Wow.
It did look right. like it when he first threw it.
Very harmless. And that'll be a 10 box. All right, an opportunity for Mike Cuccia to pick up some ground here and get within hailing distance.
I didn't think he was going to have this chance, Dick, to get back
either.
In it.
Four frames remain. He needs to throw balls like that and get a better break than he did. He liked that wood to stay on the deck.
It will, but how helpful will it be?
I think it's pretty helpful. I think he has to put the ball between the wood and the five and the eight pin. Take the pin with the ball and the... Well, he didn't do it that way.
Trying to sweep it across. Yeah.
So he puts nine in the strike and he's open. And a nine box. Needs to run the table.
And a double strike would almost be a necessity here. Just marks might not be enough. Runner-up today gets a $1,000 paycheck. So either way.
Another good first ball and a split to show for it.
Either way, a lot of money changes hands today. $1,500 to the winner and a berth in the Tournament of Champions. The higher the score, the better the position seating at the end of the year.
An open frame for Mike Cuccia in the eighth. And that'll be an eight box. He needed marks in those two frames and he came away empty. So Jeff Surette just about slammed the door here. You've got the three, the six, and the seven with the wood in front of the three pin. And there they go. And that will do it.
Another spectacular spare shot. Big split made by Jeff Surette. Should pretty much put the exclamation point on the victory today here over Mike Cuccia.
Well, he just kicked so many pieces of wood off the wall. One of them had to come over and take out the seven pin. He made this shot earlier with wood, the 2-6-10. No wood here. Let's see if he cuts the two over to the six and wipes out the 10. Ooh, he gave it a run.
How accurate is he to put the ball that close to where he wants to? Probably an inch or two from where it needed to be.
He'll take two on the right. He'll only get one. He takes an eight box.
Well, he's going to need at least one mark to get into the 400s.
They're tied at 96 in this string. The lead remains 35 pins for Mike Cuccia with two boxes remaining. Mike with a good first ball.
Playing for bonus money at this point, I think.
Missed the spare.
And a nine for Mike Cuccia, who will take home a $1,000 check and welcome him back again. A few months down the road, new rule instituted this year. Once you bowl on TV, you have to wait two ladders or 2 months, basically, before you can qualify again. This is to afford a lot more bowlers who maybe don't get on as often the opportunity to be here, to be seen.
This is a mess. And that's one he makes. He missed the single pin spare earlier and makes the cluster in the 10th frame.
Replay.
Watch it again. You've got six pins there. And he wipes them out. So he's at 115 with a ball. And it will be a good ball. He finishes with a strike inside the spare and a 125 third string for Mike Cuccia.
Replay.
Three string total of 370. as you watch that strike on the last ball. Here's Jeff Surette now to close it out with a strike of his own, but
it was on the tip of your tongue, yep. Wasn't it?
The eight pin is still standing. Jeff has already won the match. He's just trying to pin as best he can. He gets a spare. Of course, the seeding in the Tournament of Champions is based on your score in your championship match of the ladder. So he's trying to get as many as he can. He's not trying to rub it into Mike Cuccia. Put
sure.
Six in the spare.
Mike is aware of that. Needs two pins for 400.
And he's got 399.
400 generally puts you somewhere in the middle of the pack, 2, 3, 4 out of six bowlers.
And that's what it'll be, a 400 triple for Jeff Surette and a berth in the Tournament of Champions as he beats Mike Cuccia, 400 to 370, a 30-pin win. We'll come back and talk to our bowlers right after this on WNDS-TV's Candlepin Stars and Strikes from Lita Lanes in Nashua. Jeff Surette defeats Mike Cuccia. Final score of 400 to 370. Surette advancing to the Tournament of Champions. And for Mike Cuccia, we'll hand out some cash. We have $1,000 as runner-up money. And you had $50 in bonus money this week, $50 last week. So an $1,100 payday for Mike Cuccia, which ain't too shabby.
No, that's very good. I'll take it.
I figured you would.
A little bit more money than last time you were on,
yeah.
3 years ago.
Yeah, it was. It was a lot more money.
Well, you live in Pembroke, Mass, which is a bit of a haul here from Nashua, New Hampshire, yet you seem to excel every year in state tournaments here. What's keeping you from moving up to the credit?
I love New Hampshire for some reason. I bowl well up here.
Well, keep coming up and spending your money up here. It'll keep our taxes down, so you keep coming up. Now, you fell behind earlier to Jeff. He's tough when he gets the lead. He just puts the pressure on.
What it was is I got a little tentative the first string, and I was trying to aim the ball rather than throwing. Against Jeff, forget it. Can't do that. And I knew once I got behind, I really had to try to start going. But it was just too little too late. You know, the first string was to set the tempo for the match. I matched him after that, but it was just way too much. And he's such a great bowler. And he's a great guy, too, so.
When you find yourself tentative, what do you do to come out of it?
Well, I pressed a little bit. Trying to come back. I try to throw the ball maybe a little harder, try a few things that you're not supposed to try when you're in a championship match. But once again, I just give him a lot of credit. He's just a great, great kid.
Mike, thanks very much. Congratulations to you. We'll look forward to seeing you again.
Come back again.
Mike Cuccia, our runner-up here this afternoon. And now we will try our bonus ball contest and try to give you at home some cash. $40 in the bonus ball jackpot this time. And let's see if we can get a winner. And it is Irene Blanchard from Derry. And Irene, Jeff, she wants you to get 7. Can you get a 7 for Irene and put $40 in her pocket? We'll see if you can do it. Here's Jeff Surette looking for a 7. I see 6. It's the Four Horsemen still standing. So it's a consolation prize from NNR Trophies in Winchendon, Massachusetts. And that's for Irene Blanchard from Derry. Let's hand out some money. How about a check for $1,500 to Jeff Surette for winning our ladder championship? Whoops. There it goes. Easy come, easy go.
That's how easy you spend it.
Yeah, it goes that fast. And Jeff, congratulations to you. Berth in the Tournament of Champions. You've been there before. And it's a little bit easier bowling for that number one seed. You only got one match to win.
Yeah, it's definitely a lot easier. Mike already bowled, and those lights are hot. I'm pooped.
Yeah, we were told the lights were hot. They seem hotter today to the bowlers than in the past. Maybe it's just warm outside, and that has something to do with it.
Jeff, you lost your father back earlier this year, and I would imagine that he still inspires you, even though he's not with us.
Oh, definitely. He's up there watching out for me.
So how many pins do you give him credit for in today's victory?
All of them, all 400.
All 400.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, let's go now to the other part of your family. You've got a younger brother, Scotty, who comes to all the tapings, and I had a chance to watch him bowl. It looks like you've been coaching him, and he may be up gunning for your position here in about 10 years.
Yeah, he's getting out there. He's doing pretty well. You know, he's got a little bit of curve, but we're getting that out
of
there.
He's trying to straighten him out a little bit?
Yeah, once his hands get a little bit bigger, he'll be able to control it more.
Now, I mentioned earlier in the match, Jeff, I thought that I might have noticed a change in your delivery a little bit. Have you moved over to the left, or is it my imagination? Is there anything different about your delivery than what we saw last year?
It's a little more left to right, just a little more accurate that way. It's working for me.
You've had a couple of good summers. In fact, you've won the first two Tom Morgan Memorial tournaments, and I know that means a lot to you.
Oh, definitely. It's good out, early in the year to come out, with big scores and just keeps you on a roll.
Well, I know that the Morgans always had, and still do, Mikey has great affection for you, so it means that much more, I would guess.
Yeah, those, they're great guys. Mm-hmm.
Jeff, congratulations to you, a berth in the Tournament of Champions. We'll see you down the road.
All right, way to go.
Jeff Surette, our winner of the tournament of the first ladder series of the season, which earns him a berth in the Tournament of Champions and a 400 triple. Of course, he's the first to get in the tournament. We don't know where he'll end up, but...